But this one must be the cream of the dairy. Father, this fist in love. I feel like a Chinese toy. Information that a schooner carrying a distinguished Fenian hero had been hovering about the coast, intending to land her passengers on shore. So a gunboat has been sent round these waters, and we are under orders to cooperate with her. Deuced bore, not to say ridiculous. There's no foundation for the scare, but nevertheless we find ourselves quartered here without any resources.
What I regret, I cannot extend to you the hospitality which should have been. An unmarried girl is unable to pay the water. Oh, even two unmarried girls are unable.
Finest shooting in the west of Ireland. The mountains above here are full of grouse and the streams full of salmon.
The captain obeyed leave to sport over your domain. Shall I spare you the humiliation of confessing that you're not lady in your own house, much less mistress of the manor? Do you see that ruin yonder? Oh, it is the admiration of the traveller and the study of the painter who come from far and near to copy it. It was the home of my forefather. When they kept open hearts for the poor friend, stranger. The mortgagee is but a bit now, so visitors pay sixpence a head to admire the place. And their guide points across to the cabin, where the remains of the old family, two lonely girls, live. God knows how you ask leave to kill game on Swinnemore's kindly. Do you see that salmon? It was snared last night in the Pulley Britain by Khan the Shaughran. He killed those grouse at daylight by the side of the monitor. That's why he would, Captain. We owe it to a poacher.
You have to suffer bitterly indeed for ages of family imprudence and the Irish extravagance of your ancestors.
Yes, sir. The extravagance of their love for their country and the imprudence of their fidelity to their faith.
But you cannot be without some relatives.
No, I have a brother. The Irish
state. Is he abroad?
Yes. He's a convict where he had his sentence in Australia.
I beg your pardon. I did not know. Have you any relatives?
Yeah. I am the affianced wife of her brother.
Really, ladies, I have to offer a thousand apologies.
I do not accept one. It carries insult to the man I love.
Well, at least you will allow me to regret having aroused such distressing memories.
You think they are asleep?
No, naturally, no, of course not. What I meant was, I'm astray on an Irish bog here, and every step I take gets me deeper in the mire.
How confused he is! That's a good fellow, although he is an Englishman. I am very sorry we have not the power to grant you a privilege, which, you see, we do not enjoy.
Hello? Is anyone at home?
Here comes a gentleman who can oblige you.
Hello?
This stentorian gentleman.
Mr. Corey Kinchela, one who has trimmed his fortunes with prudence and his conscience with economy.
Where the devil is everybody? So there you are. I have to stable my own horse. My service to you, sir. I believe I have the honor of addressing Captain Molyneux. I'm just back from Dublin, and I thought I'd stop on my road to tell you that the court has decreed the sale of this estate under foreclosure, and in 2 months, you'll have to turn out.
In 2 months? Then even this poor shelter will be taken from us.
Well, I'm afraid the rightful owner will want to see the worth of his money. Ah, but never fear, to handsome girls like yourself will not be long wanting a shelter. Or a welcome.
Sorry.
Hi, Captain! I'll be picking shoes for them anywhere I'm thinking.
This fellow is awfully offensive to me.
Yes, well, I've been away for the last few weeks, so I've not been able to pay my respects to you officers. And to invite you all to sport over my... this property. You're right welcome, Captain. My name is Kinchula. Mr. Corey Kinchula of Ballyragghacarse. Well, I'll be proud to see my tablecloth under your chin. I don't know why one of these two girls didn't introduce me.
I paid me the compliment of presuming that I had no desire to form your acquaintance.
What? Do you know, sir, you're talking to a person of position and character?
I don't care a straw for your position, and I don't like your character.
Do you mean to insult me, sir?
I am incapable of it, in the presence of ladies. But believe I should be entitled to do so if you insulted them in mine. I ask your pardon for the liberty I took when I presented myself.
Oh, the liberty you took with him when he presented himself. Clear, dear Collins.
We'll meet again, sir.
I hope not. Good evening.
I would delay you, Captain, but you have a long way across the mountain, and the darkness is falling. The road is treacherous.
Aye, the devil guided me past the night in the bog hole up to his neck. Listen hither. Sure, I don't want to be too hard upon you. To be sure, the sale of this place will never cover my mortgage on it. It'll come to me every acre of it. Besides that, the law ought to throw in your own sweet self as a make-weight square, my account. See now, there's your brother, Robert Folliot, going to rot over there in Australia. And here in a few weeks, you both will be without a roof over your heads. Nah, isn't that a cruel thing entirely to let this go on? And if this girl would only say the word, I'd make her Mrs. Kinchula. And I've got a hole in the ear of the county member. Sure, he'll get Robert the run of the country. As free as a fish in a pond he'd be over there. And stop! You shall send him £1,000 which I'll give you on your wedding day.
I'd rather starve in jail with Robert Follett than own the county of Sligo if I had to carry you as a mortgage on it.
Do you think the boy cares what becomes of you or who owns you? Not a hayport! I've got them all safe under lock and key. See that now? Not one thought, not a sign from him. And here I am, every day in the week, like a dog at your door. What's too hard on me entirely? I've some sacred scheming behind my back to ruin me entirely in your heart. And I know that it is the same as sending over to Robert Folliot the money, without which he'd starve out right beyond there. And I'd like to find out who it is.
I am the man, Mr. Kinchula.
Father Dolan! May I ask, sir, on what grounds you dare to impeach me in the good opinion of these girls?
Certainly. Miss O'Neill, Claire, my dear, will you leave me alone a while with Mr. Kinchula?
Anything more?
There is! You hope to buy the man's inheritance for an old song when it is sold. Thus you fulfill the trust confided to you by your benefactor, his poor father, whose hand you held when he expired in my arms. Thus you have kept the oath to the dead.
Would not every acre of it have escheated to the crown, as the estate of a convicted felon? Only it was me who saved him from folly off by getting his family to make over before the sentence was pronounced upon him.
Yes, to make it over to you and trust for these two girls, his sister and his betrothed.
To be sure, wasn't you mine? I'm helped to persuade you. More of a token. You were a witness to the deed.
I was. I helped you to defraud the orphan boy. And since then have been a witness how you have robbed these helpless women. Oh, beware, Kinchula. When these lands were torn from Owen Roe, Neil in the old times, he laid his curse upon the spoilers. For Swinnamore was the dowry of his bride, Grace Folliot. Since then, many a strange family have tried to hold possession of the place. But every year, one of them would die. The land seemed to swallow them up, one by one. Until the O'Neills and Folliots returned. None other thrived upon it.
Sure, that's the reason I want Art O'Neill for my wife. Wouldn't that keep the odd blood to the fore? Eh, sir? Why wouldn't you put in a good word for me to the girl? Do I ask better than to give all I have back to the family? Sure, there's nothing, sir, done that couldn't be mended that way.
I'd rather rate the service over her grave and hear the sobs fall in her coffin and speak the holy words to make her your wife. Corrie Kinchula, I know that it was by your means serve these ends. My darling boy, her lover, was denounced and convicted.
That's false.
'Tis true. But the truth is locked in my soul, and heaven keeps the key.
Some false have a curse confessed on me again. Very well, sir. And out of this house, these girls shall turn homeless and beggar.
Not homeless while I have a roof over me. And not beggars, I thank God, who gives me the crust to share with them.
How could he know that I had any hand in bringing young Folliot to the dock? Who could have turned tail on me?
Sir.
Hand me Duff.
I saw your coupling beyond under the hedge, and I knew your set of positions.
I have great news.
Entirely for you. News enough to burst the budget.
You're always finding a mare's nest.
Well, I've got one now in a double egg.
Well, out with it.
There was a fire last night, and Rathgar and Head. You know what that means.
Mm-hmm. Signal to some smuggler at sea that the coast is clear, so that he can come in and land his cargo.
Tibble of kegs landed from that ship, barring only one man, to shore. Not a boy was on the strand to meet the ship, nor a car, nor a skip to hurry things off. Only one thing, and that was Khan, the Shaughran. 'Twas himself that liked the signal. 'Twas him that stood up to his mill in the salt sea to carry the man ashore. I seen it all as lay on the flat of his stomach on the edge of the cliff, looked down the pair of them below.
Well, what's all this to me?
Wait, sure, I'll hatch the egg for you. Who's that, says I, to myself, that Khan would carry as tender as a mother would hold a child? Who's that, says I, to myself, that Khan would caper around for all the world with a dog just loosed? Who's that he's holding by the two hands of him? It was Moya Dolan herself he had before him, instead of some ragged sailor boy.
Well, did you find out who it was?
Ah, maybe I didn't get snug enough. They passed close by me, talking low-like. But I heard his voice, and I saw the man as plain as I see you now.
Saw him?
Robert Folliot.
But himself, I tell you.
Are you sure?
Am I sure? Do you think I can mistake the face that turned upon me in the courtyard when they sentenced him in my evidence? For the voice that said, if there's justice in heaven, you and I'll meet again in this side of grave. Then, says he, have your soul ready? And the luck he fixed upon me shriveled up my soul inside like a boiled cackalot you might pick out of the pen. Am I sure? I wish I was as sure of heaven.
He's escaped from the penal settlement. Aye, that's it. But where would he go to straight but here? Into the trap? Baited with the girl he loves?
There'll be a price after for him, sir. And your honor would you wait to earn an honest penny. Wouldn't they hang him this time? Holy God, I'd only be peaceably without the way for good.
Listen to me. Do you know what took me to Dublin? I heard that the Queen had resolved to release the Fenian prisoners under sentence.
Mother alive! I'm a carp!
I saw the secretary! He mistook my fear for hope. It's true, says he. I'm expecting every day to get the dispatch. I wish you joy.
I'd like to see your face when you got the puzzle over the gold.
Robert Folly, I've returned. A free man, he'll throw his estates in the chancery.
Where will he throw me?
Well, he's a fugitive convict still. Can't we deal with him?
If his own people knew he was among them by a live coal and keg of gunpowder, not giving an idea, County Sligo.
I know it. High and low, they love him as they hate me. Bad cess to them.
Bad cess. Ach, never fear. He'll keep in the dark for his own sake.
Keep a watch on the Shaughran. Find out where the pair of them lie in hiding. And bring me the news back to Ballyragget House. Meanwhile, I'll think what's best to be done. I'll be on the quick. Robert Folliot here. 10 ages. I'm ruined, horse and foot! And the Wall of Connaught and the Court of Chancery on my back. Well, Harvey Duff is right. It's life or death with me and him. Well, it shall be life with you, Art O'Neill. And death to him that parts us.
My love for the Shaughran. Ah, my heart was not so much to blame for after all.
Hello?
That's not his voice.
Hello?
Why, it's the man in the uniform of an officer. Ah.
He's seen me.
Take care, sir. Don't take that path. Turn to the right. Round that boulder. That's the road. Gad, another step and he would have been over the cliff. There's obviously some stranger who's lost his way.
What an infernal country! First I was nearly smothered in a bog, and then, thanks to you, my good fellow, I escaped breaking my neck. Do you know the way to Ballyragget? How far is it to the barracks?
2 miles.
Oh, Irish miles, of course.
I shall be happy to show you the road, but regret, I can't be your guide. The safest for a stranger is by the cliff to Shillabeg.
But I have just come from there.
From Shillabeg?
Oh, I shall not regret to revisit the place. Charming spot. I've just passed there, the sweetest hour of my life.
You met the lady of the house, I presume?
Pardon me, sir. I mistook your yachting costume. Perhaps you are acquainted with Miss Follett.
Ah, yes. But we haven't met for some time. I thought you referred to art. I mean Miss O'Neill.
She's charming, of course, but Miss Follett is an angel. She has so occupied my thoughts that I've lost my way. In fact, instead of going straight home, I've been revolving in an orbit round that house by a kind of centrifugal attraction, of which she is the center.
But surely you admire Miss O'Neill?
She is well enough, bright little thing, but besides Claire Follett...
I prefer the beauty of Miss O'Neill.
I don't admire your taste.
Well, let us drink to each of them.
With pleasure, if you can supply the opportunity. I see you are provided. Allow me to present myself. Captain Molyneux of the 49th. Here's to Miss Claire Follett.
And here's to Miss Art O'Neill.
I beg your pardon, I did not catch your name.
Didn't mention it.
This liquor is American whiskey, I presume.
Do you find anything wrong about it?
No, nothing whatever. But it reminds me of a duty I have to perform. We have orders to capture a dangerous person who has been or will be landed in this coast. And as these rocks are just the sort of place where he might find refuge...
Not at all unlikely. I'll keep a lookout for him.
I propose to revisit this spot again tonight with the Vale of Men. Here's your health.
Sir, accept my regards. Here's good luck to you.
What's that?
It's a ring at the bell. A friend of mine is waiting for me on the cliff above. It's Con.
Oh, I beg pardon. Farewell.
Con. You mightn't fare too well if you ascend that path alone.
Why not?
Well, because my friend's at the top of it, and if he saw you coming out alone, he would think I had been caught. And he got the Shaughran might poach the captain.
Well, if he met me, what then?
You see, the poor fellow, he's slightly mad at one point. He can't stand the sight of one colour, and that's red. You see, when he was young, his mother was frightened by this mad bull. And the minute Corn sees a bit of scarlet there, such as your coat there, the bull just breaks out of him. And he might toss you over the cliff. So, by your leave.
This is the most extraordinary country I was ever in.
Shooting and fishing and sporting and love making. shriek of a bugle to the whip, and in the minute the cat caught herself again, and the whole field came roaring past. Then the mare lost her head and tore at the gate. Stacks as I hit it, and I set the case of rope over her head and into her mouth. Now, why the coming in the beast? She was quiet in a minute. Come on now, says I. Easy. And I flung my leather faster. The jeepers! How sooner was I on her bare back than holy racket! She was a rabbit of feet, and here I got it from him out. Yikes, son!
Heard voices outside.
It was only the bed.
And I heard somebody singing.
Just a kettle, Uncle.
Go tell that pig not to come here till he's cured. And if I hear any strange kettle singing round here, my kettle will boil over.
Sure, Uncle, I never knew that happened. Would you put your fire out?
Ah, see now, Moya. That ragamuffin con will be your ruin. What makes you so fond of the road?
All the faces I got from when I was a child, and the hard words you gave me since.
See, one good quality under heaven, he has it forgiven.
He loves me.
Love? Oh, that word covers more sin than charity. I think I hear it raining, Moya, and they would not keep a dog out on such a night. You may let him stand out of the wet, but don't let him open his mouth. Give me a cup of tea, Moya. Hope to be stronger than the last.
What
do I do? There's tea stopping. There's no more tea in the house. Well,
haven't you a word to say for yourself? Divil a one,
Your Reverence. You're going to ruin.
I am.
And you want to take a decent girl along with you? What sort of a life do you lead? What is your occupation? stealing salmon out of a river of a night.
Oh, sir, I'm not so bad as that. But who will confess to a bucket of trout? And the salmon's out of season.
And don't you go poaching grouse on the hillside?
I do. Didn't the lie in it?
Do you know where all this leads to?
Well, along with the grouse, I go to pot.
Bless me, Moya! Moya! This tea is very strong. It has a curious taste.
Maybe the water's to blame. I'm going to be in smoke.
And it smells of whiskey.
No. That's not the tea you smell, sir. It's me.
That reminds me! Didn't you make me a promise last Easter? A blessed promise made at your two knees that you'd live off drink.
I did.
Yes, one thimbleful. I allowed that concession, but no more.
God bless you, did. And I kept my word.
Kept your word? How dare you say that? Didn't I find you 10 days after, stretched out drunk as a fiddler at Tim O'Malley's wake?
You did. Bad luck to me.
You took only one thimbleful.
Look at the drop more. If you see this, will you listen to me, sir? I tell you how it was. When they asked me to the wake, I went. Oh, no, I wouldn't deceive you. I went. There was the Mackays and the Malone.
I don't want to hear about that. Come to the drink.
First, I came to that soon enough. But after blessing the Keeners and the rest of them, I couldn't despise a drink now out of respect for the corpse, long life to it. But boys, says I, I'm on a pudding, says I. Is there a thimble in the house, says I? For a divil a drop more than a full of it will pass my lips this blessed day.
Ah.
As the devil's luck would have it, there was only one thimble in the house. That was a tailor's thimble, and you couldn't get a gun. I got me going first, though.
Ah, come. I'm afraid liquor's not the worst of your doings. We lost sight of you lately for more than 6 months. In what jail did you pass that time?
I was on the travels.
On your travels? Where?
Round the world. A seesaw. After the master was tucking us into the way, the heart seemed to go to me entirely, you know. I'd stand by the say and look over and watch his ships sail away to where he may be. Till one day, the landing grew too big for me belly, and I jumped into the coast guard boat, stuck up the say, and went to say.
Bless the boy. You didn't think you could get to Australia in a skiff.
I didn't think. I went. Oh, that night, I cast about, and the day after that, and that night, till... I come across a big ship, stop the fight, take me aboard, I'm out to be course. And they put me up on deck and took me before the captain. Where are you from, says he? Shouldn't have been, says I, and I'd be advised yet to lay me anywhere handy by there. You'll have to go to Melbourne first, says he. Is that anywhere in the county, Sligo? Well, yo, my don, says he, you won't stay home for 6 months. Then I said something weird through. Poor Devon, says the captain. I'm sorry for you, but you must cross the ocean. What sort of work can you do best? Well, I can play the fiddle, says I. Take on four to make good terms, says he. And that's how I got the passage to Australia.
You rogue! You boarded that ship on purpose!
Oh, did you get near the old master? And did you find him, Colin?
I did. Nah, sir. Whenever he saw me, he put his 2 arms round my neck and sobbed them through to me like when we were children together. What brings you here at all, says he? To bring you back with me, says I. And that's impossible, says he.
I watched.
So is the salmon in the Glen of Moy, says I. But I get him. So is the grouse on the Cayman A. But I poach him. And now I've come to poach you, says I. And I did it.
Is this the truth you're telling me? You found him?
See? And in fine condition.
He escaped! I'm free! Tell me!
Yeah, he must speak for himself now.
Father Nolan!
Robert! My darling boy! Oh, blessed day! Do I hold you to my heart again?
There's nobody looking here. He's been hiding on the seashore among the rocks a whole day and two nights.
Nothing but seaweed for his bed.
Oh, if I
Come, sit ye all down, and let me see ye all around me once again. And to think I cannot offer you a glass of wine, for warm your welcome with a glass of liquor. I've not got a bottle in the house. The rogue!
You may thank poor Con, who contrived my escape. I made my way across to America.
Get over my surprise to see my blessed child there sitting by the fireside. Now, we'll all drink his health.
Send him out to drink, Elvis.
The tailor's your reprobate. You ready? Now then, here's his health and long life to him. May heaven watch over him.
At such an hour, but my duty is imperative. A convict escaped from penal servitude has been landed on this coast, and I am charged with his capture. Miss Follett, I am sorry to be obliged to perform so painful a duty in your presence, and in yours, Miss O'Neill.
Especially, sir, when the man you seek is my brother,
and Firefire's husband.
Believe me, I would exchange places with him, if I could.
Please, sir, there's a red dog, sir, sitting at the back door. He's been performing awful.
Assurance gives me hope that we have been misled.
The house is very small, sir. Here is a bedroom. Let your men search it.
I shall be a
obliged, sir, to visit every room, sound every piece of furniture from the roof to the cellar. But the indignity of the proceeding is more offensive to my feelings than it can be to yours. I will accept your simple assurance that the person we're in search of is not in this house. Give me that, and I will withdraw my men.
Oh, thank you, Captain. Thank you.
Save him, sir. Oh, save him.
Oh, God. Help me in this great temptation.
You will not betray him. Speak. Say he is not here.
Await your reply.
The lad. The person you seek. Oh, my poor boy. Oh, sir, for mercy's sake, don't ask me. He has been here. But...
He was gone? He went before we arrived?
Yes. Yes. He went to wait for us. He didn't hear us all.
Have I your word, as a priest, sir, that Robert Follett is not under this roof?
No, sir. Robert Follett is here.
I'm very sorry for it.
How pale you are. Did he resist?
Give me a glass of spirits.
Recover yourself. Is he wounded?
Tibble a scratch. But I am.
Where?
Never mind.
You're faint. Come and sit down.
No, I'm easier on my feet.
How did it happen?
Well, I was peeping through the keyhole of the kitchen door.
I mean, harm was he taken?
I did not stop to see. When he caught sight of my face again in the windy, his own turned as white as your shirt. I believe he knew me.
That's impossible. That black wig disguises you completely. You've shaved off your great red whiskers. Thank God, your own mother wouldn't know you.
No, she wouldn't. Last time I went home, she pelted me with a poker. But if the people around here had an idea, I was Harvey Duff. They wouldn't survive me at pieces as big as the one I left in that mouth of a devil of a dog.
Don't be afraid, my good fellow. I'll take care of you.
To be taken care of at the same time. There's a pair of us, Mr. Kitchell, that mind me now. We're harnessed at the same pole, and as I'm through, you must struggle.
What do you mean?
I mean I've been your partner in this game to cheat young Foliot out of his liberty first, then out of his state, and now out of his wife. With my share.
Your share? Share of what?
Oh no. Not the wife. Take her and welcome. But where's my share of the money?
Were you not handsomely paid at the time for doing your duty?
My duty?
Was it my duty to come down here among the people disguised as a female delegate and pass himself off for head centre so I could swear him in and denounce him? Who was it to give me the office to trap young Foliot? Who was it to pick Dandy Donovan and send him across the sail and his young wife down the mad
hash? Not so loud.
My own son was sentenced in my evidence. Take your share of that. Give me some of what I've earned.
You want a share of my fortune?
A share of our fortune?
Every penny I possess is invested in this estate. If Robert Foliot returns a free man, I couldn't hold more of it than would stick to my brogues when I was kicked out. Listen to this letter, which I find here waiting for me tonight. It's from London. On Her Majesty's service, the Home Office. In reply to your inquiries concerning Robert Foliot undergoing penal servitude, I am directed by His Lordship to inform you that Her Majesty has been pleased to extend a full pardon to the Fenian prisoners.
Pardoned? I'm a card.
But as Robert Foliot has effected his escape, the pardon will not extend to him unless he should reconstitute himself a prisoner.
Oh, Lord, that's exactly what he's done. He's given himself up.
Was he not captured?
No bad looks, but our scheme to capture him has only qualified him for a pardon.
What? Has an infernal fate played such a trick on me?
The devil will have his due.
His freedom and return here is your death warrant, Duff! And my ruin!
I'll take Nick's ship to foreign parts.
Stay! The news is known only to ourselves.
In a couple of days we'll be all over Ireland. Then what'll I do? Where will I go? They will let him out alive. Will I swear permission against myself and get sent to jail for protection?
Listen. I have a plan.
Can I rely on your help?
I'll do anything, short of murder. But I did something to do that for me. What's to be done?
I'll visit him in prison. And offer him the means to escape.
No.
What's more likely than he should be killed whilst making the attempt?
The soldiers will not draw a trigger bar and a magistrate advised to give the order.
Ah, but the police will. You'll go at once to the police barracks at Sligo, pick your men, tell them you apprehend an attempted rescue. The late attack on the police van at Manchester and the explosion at Clerkenwell Prison in London will warrant extreme measures.
The police won't fire if he doesn't defend himself.
But he will.
Where will he get the arms?
I'll provide them for him.
Corey Kinchler, the devil must be proud of you.
Must get some of our own people to help. And if the police hesitate, sure it's the duty of every loyal subject to kill a fugitive convict. Now, what men can we rely on a pinch?
There's Sullivan and Doyle.
Which Doyle?
Jim Doyle.
Jim Doyle?
Aye, the man with big carbuncle on the end of his nose. Then there's Riley.
Riley?
Aye.
He's transported.
No, he's not.
Ah, but he will. And you'll be hanged.
And so will you and Mangan and all their smuggling crew.
Where can you find them?
At the Goat's Nest, they expect the lugger in it every tide.
Have them ready and sober tonight. You come to me for instructions at midday. That'll do. You'll fall into that trap. It can't fail.
Harvey Duff, take a friend's advice. Take your little pickings and your passage across the salt sea. Find some place where a rogue can live peaceably. Have some show. And a chance of making an honorable living. Darling, do not sob so bitterly. Sure, that will do no good and only spoil your blue eyes.
What's the good of my eyes if I can't see him? Let me cry. God help me. What else can I do? Oh, if I could only see him, speak to him 1 minute. Do you think they would let me in?
I have sent a letter to the captain. Moya has carried it to the barracks.
Us.
But I could not go.
Why not?
I could not ask that Englishman a favour.
You speak unkindly and unjustly. That man acted with a gentle forbearance and a respect for my character and our sorrow I cannot forget.
Nor can I.
It made a deep impression on my heart.
Yes, a bitter curse on the day I ever laid eyes on him.
Oh, Claire, you wrong him. Surely I have no cause to regard him as a friend. But you did not see the tears in his eyes when I appealed to his mercy.
Didn't I?
Poor fellow. He suffered for what he was obliged to do. You should not hate the man.
I don't! And that's what ails me!
Are you mad?
I am! I've tried to hate him and I can't! Do you think I was blind to all you saw? I've tried to shut him out, but I can only shut him in. I hate his country and his people.
But you were never there.
Never! And I wish they had never been here, particularly this fellow, who has the impudence to upset all my principles with his chalky smile of bloodless courtesy. I can't stand the ineffable resignation with which he makes a fool of himself and me. Well, have you seen him? Can't you speak? I knew it when I get my breath. Yes, I saw him.
Kept you so long then.
Pawn came back with me. And knowing you did not want him round here, I was trying to get away from him. That's what kept me. But he was at my heels all the way and Tatters at his heels. A nice three we made along the road.
Where is he?
They're both outside.
The pair of vagabonds! Why does he not go home?
He says the old woman is no consolation.
Is the fella so insensible to our sorrow that he sets it to the tune of a jug of punch?
Oh, don't blame poor Con, father. The fellow is so full of sport, I believe he would sing at his own funeral.
Long life, Jesus, is a good word.
Now, Cattle, I want you to behave. Lie down.
Where have you been all night?
And where would I be for the one that's sitting with these people up with hearts and songs and the diversion?
Diversion?
They have all the
did you great wrong. I ask your pardon.
But what is to be done? I've only got news for 5 words at the crossroads, and I go away and help him out before tonight.
Yes, you would raise the country to attack the barracks and rescue him. I will not give countenance to violence.
It's the shortest way out, Father.
Oh, anyway, but that.
Come into my kitchen. Have you nothing else since yesterday? The guard has left me just all night.
There's a knock at the door.
To see Claire.
I know that.
Why do you not let him in?
I'm trying to keep him out.
Good day, sir. I ventured to intrude in person to bring you this order, necessary to obtain admission to see Mr. Follett. And that I might entreat you to confirm your ill will for this painful tune I had to perform last night.
Oh, no, sir! You had to deprive us of a limb! And I suppose you performed the operation professionally well. Do you come for the fee? Form of our gratitude?
Forgive her, sir. Claire, this is too bad.
No, not at all. Pray don't mention it, I assure you.
This letter is signed by Mr. Kitchener. Are we indebted to him for the favour?
The prisoner is now in the custody of the civil park, and Mr. Kitchener is the magistrate of the district.
Come, Art. Come, Claire.
Make me feel more acutely than I do the misery of my condition. I did not sleep a wink last night.
And how many winks do you suppose I got?
I tried to act with as much tenderness as the nature of my duty would permit.
That's the worst part of it.
You reproach me with my gentleness?
I do! You have not even left us the luxury of complaint.
Really? I don't understand you.
No wonder I don't understand myself sometimes.
Well, if you don't understand yourself, you shall understand me, Miss Follett. You oblige me to take refuge from your cruelty and place myself under the protection of your generosity. You extort from me a confession which I feel is premature, for our acquaintance has been short.
And not sweet.
I ask your pity for my position last night, when I found myself obliged to arrest the brother of the woman I love. Never see you again. Heaven bless you. Farewell.
Don't go!
Do I hear right? Bid me stay?
Am I mad?
Spotted. I accept it, whatever it may be.
Save my brother.
I'll do my best. Anything else?
Never speak of love to me again.
Never. Never. On my honor, I will never breathe.
Until he is free.
Then may I? May I?
Not a word.
Not a word.
Quarters.
We shall be glad to get rid of him. It is a police business. All men don't half like it.
Now, I'll know at once by his greeting whether those girls have been speaking about me.
Kinsler, my dear friend, I knew you wouldn't fail me.
It's all right. Pardon me, Mr. Folliot, but you forget your position and mine. I bear Her Majesty's commission as Justice of the Peace, and whatever friendship once united us, it ceased to be when you became a rebel.
Do I hear all right? Your letters to me breathe the most devoted...
Forgive me for the presence of that fellow. I was obliged to pay the magistrate.
He took my breath away.
Oh, didn't I do it well? My devotion to you and the precious charge you left in my care exposes me to suspicion. I'm watched. I have to preserve my character. I'm obliged to put on airs. And I'm your mortal enemy. Mind that.
You.
Every man, woman, and child in the county Sligo believe it. And hate me. I played my part so well that your sister and Miss O'Neill even took offense at my performance.
No.
Yes. They actually believe I am what I'm obliged to appear. And they hate me cordially. I'm the biggest blackguard.
You. My best friend.
Well, I don't mind it. See, the truth is, I'm afraid if I betrayed my game to them, you know the weakness of the sex, then they could not have kept my secret.
But surely Father Dora...
Well, he's just bad.
Well, forgive them.
I do.
The time will come when they will repent their usage of you.
Aye. By my soul it will.
They have no friend, no protector but you. Now my chains be more firmly riveted than ever.
You must escape.
It's impossible. How and when?
Tonight! Tomorrow, when you're removed to Sligo jail, it might not be so easy. But tonight, I can help you.
To regain my freedom.
Is that ship that landed you within reach?
Every night at 8 o'clock, she runs on shore. A bonfire left on Rathgarret Head is to be the signal for her to send off her skiff under the ruins of St. Bridget's Abbey to take me on board.
That signal shall be fired tonight. And you'll be there to make the boat.
Do you indeed mean this, Kitch? Will you risk this for my sake?
I'd lay down my life if you wanted it.
What am I to do?
Give me your promise that you'll not breathe a word to a mortal about the place I'm going to propose. Neither to your sister, nor to Miss O'Neill, nor above all to Father Dolan.
Must I play a part to deceive them?
My life and liberty are staked in the attempt as well as yours.
I give you the promise.
Tonight, your quarters will be changed to the old gate tower. Now wait till dark and use this hammer and chisel to pick out the stones that form the back of the fireplace in your room. Now the wall there is only one course thick.
You are sure?
Yeah. Con the Shaughran was shut up in that cell last spring, and he picked his way out with a two-pronged fork. He was getting out of the hole he had made for himself whenever they caught him. The wall has been rebuilt, but has not served as a prison since.
And where shall I find myself when I am outside?
In a yard, enclosed by four low walls. Now, there is a door in one of them that's bolted on the inside. Open that, and you're free.
Are there no sentinels posted there?
No, but if there is, a pistol that will clear your road. Now, I'll put Duff inside that door, and it'll be an end to him.
Take it back. I will not buy my liberty at the price of any man's life. I will take my chance, but stay, the signal in Rathgarren Head. Well, who will light the bonfire? Hark, it's Con. Do you hear? Poor fellow. He's playing. I'm under your window, darling. Ah, I can employ him. Yes. Now, how will he do it? How will I send him word?
You won't betray me.
No, no. Be at Rathgarren Head tonight, beside the tar barrel. What signal can I give him that he might be able to see or hear across the bay?
When you hear two gunshots on St. Bridget's Abbey, light the fire.
When you hear two gunshots, for that purpose I accept the pistol.
No matter for what purpose, he'll use it to serve mine. And if they hang him for killing Harvey Duff, well, I'll be after killing the both words with the one stone.
Beg the sergeant to come here.
What are you going to do?
You'll see. Here's the sergeant.
They say they've got a pass to see you.
Show them in.
Now you won't mind a word they say against me. Watch their manner, mind.
Not I. I know you better.
Robert!
Mr. Kitchener.
I am surprised to find you here, sir.
Did you hear?
All right.
You do not know that man.
Oh, yes, he does. I've made a clean breast of it.
Yes, he has told me all.
How I brought all of you to ruin, and betrayed my trust, and grew rich and fat on the plunder. Well, I defy you to make me out a bigger blackguard than I've already painted myself. So, my service to you.
Patrick made a clean sweep of all the venomous reptiles in Ireland. Some of the vermin must have found refuge in the bodies of men such as that.
This is the first uncharitable word I ever heard you utter.
Heaven forgive me for it, and him.
You're right. My vocation is to pray for sinners, not revile them.
And mine is to comfort you, and not to bring our complaints to add to your misfortune.
Hold up your hearts. Mine's full of hope.
Hope? Where do you find it?
Her eyes. Huh. May as well ask me where I find love. I was in prison when I was liberated on American soil. The chains were on my soul when I stretched it, longing across the ocean towards my home. But now I am in prison. This narrow cell is Ireland. But I breathe my native air, and I'm free.
Ah, they will send you back again.
The future belongs to heaven. The present is our own.
I believe I was wrong to come here at all. I feel like a mourning band on a white hat.
Sorry to disturb you, sir, but we are ordered to shift your quarters. You will occupy the room in the old gate hall. The guard is waiting, sir, when you are ready.
I am prepared to accompany you.
Must we leave you?
For the present, but we shall soon meet again. Now, we indulge in a strange humour of mine. You know the rooms of St. British Abbey where we have so often sat together?
Can I ever forget it? We go there often. The place is full of you.
Go there tonight at 9 o'clock.
I'll offer up a prayer in your shrine.
Aye, with all my heart, for I may want it.
What do you mean? There's some mischief going on. I know it by his eye. He used to wear the same look when he was going to give me the slip, and be off from his Latin grammar to play truant with Con the Shaughran.
Ask me nothing. Right now, see only one word. Look.
Ah, 'tis the finest word in the Irish language.
There's a finer. Bend.
And love is the mother of those heavenly twins. I declare, my heart has lifted up between you, as if your young ones were its wings.
Good night, and not for the last time.
Good night.
I leave my heart with you. God bless you.
Remember, tonight at the Abbey.
At 9 o'clock.
I shall be there.
Shh.
Sends away like this. Too hard.
arrived from Sligo to relieve me of my charge.
But your soldiers are there.
Soldiers will not move without orders. Besides, my men have such a distaste for this business that I believe if left to defend their prisoner against an attempt to rescue him, they would disgrace themselves.
Get him away. An attempt will be made tonight.
No, leave us.
Well, good day, Captain.
Is it far?
No.
Not far. May I be permitted to go part of the road beside you?
Oh, pray. Do not neglect it, just in my account. Besides, I wish to consult my feelings in solitude, uninfluenced by your presence.
That sweet confession gives me hope and courage.
Leave me. Light a meditative cigar and go back to your duty. Leave me to wander by the light of the rising moon and sit down in the rocks beside the sea.
How good you are. An angel.
A light tower.
That's some excuse to follow her a little way. Miss Folliot? Pardon me, but my cigar is out. And, well, you have my matches. Oh, don't come back, I beg.
Thank you.
rat. Now, this brickwork seems loose enough to pull out. But if that goes, the rest seems pretty shaky. They should fall together. There's a schooner creeping in with the tide. I can reach the ruins by the seashore. Yes, the rocks should conceal me. Then, one brief moment, my darling.
Speak, they're close by.
Celery?
Yes, with them those smuggling thieves, man and soul of the riding and dying. They're guiding the boat. Mongrel curs go through that. They know every hole in the rocks.
But who'll set the match to the taffrail on that gang head?
Never fear, sir. Miss Clare's there by this time. Watching the waiting for the two gunshots, Your Honour, will fire in the ruins beyond.
Right. Now, where is my pistol? Can't find it. It's gone. No, it can't be. By heaven! It must have fallen from my pocket as I climbed the wall.
Mother alive, what do we do now?
bag of bones on the little house of the red herring. I'm cut in and cross your scent. I gave them off, never fear. But Jesus, I'll show them the finest run of the hunting season.
How, Con? How?
Easy. Look, we'll come down the cliff above. Slip out this way. When we get down the corner, we must avoid them. You take the sword along, and I'll take the cliff above.
Something to offend you. Tell me what it is. It will afford me much pleasure to plead for pardon for what I haven't done.
You want to know what ailed me?
Yes.
Right. You see that tar barrel?
Gracious. What has a tar barrel got to do with my offense?
Nothing, but it has everything to do with mine.
I wonder whether there's madness in the family.
Do you see that tar barrel?
I see something like a tar barrel in that pile of brushwood.
Will you oblige me with a match?
Certainly. There's no doubt about it. So lovely and yet so afflicted.
Captain.
I feel even more tenderly towards her now than I did.
Captain, if I were to ask you to light that bonfire, would you do it?
With pleasure. It's the moon which affects her. I wish I'd brought an umbrella.
Captain Molyneux, my brother had a bit from the prison guarded by your soldiers. This pile of fuel, when lighted, will be the signal for the schooner you see yonder to send a boat ashore to take off the fugitive. I have been a decoy to entice you away from your duty, so that I might deprive your men of the orders they await to pursue my brother who has broken jail. Now you understand my conduct, Captain.
Miss Folliot.
Now you understand why every tender word you have spoken has tortured me like poison. Every throb in your honest heart. I feel like a knife in mine.
I thought you were mad. I fear as I have been so.
You can redeem your professional honor. You can repair the past. I have no means here of lighting that beacon. If the signal is not fired, my brother will be recaptured. But the blood that revolts in my heart against what I am doing is the same that beats in his. He would disdain to owe his liberty to my duplicity. And to your infatuation. There's your road, Captain. Good night.
So I'm being her dupe? No. No, she was not laughing at me. She is not laughing at me as one who. See, she has thrown herself on the ground. I hear her sobs. I cannot leave her alone. And in this wild place, yet what can I do to? I don't know what to do. There again.
cannot let her lie there.
Drinking and six of the O'Kellys to come.
dance and supper party in honor of the melancholy occasion?
They are only going to wait for a con.
Yes, and your £5 will be spent on whiskey and cakes and consolation and fiddlers and grief and meat and drink for the poor.
What a compound! You Irish do make something.
Never mind, Whitney Mix. Have you done anything?
I've been thinking.
Thinking? What a girl of thinking! My cousin has disappeared! The country is full of police and soldiers, and yet two girls have been carried off under your noses, and there you stand like a goose! Thinking?
Pray don't be so impetuous. You Irish are so impetuous.
I won't be called you Irish.
I beg your pardon. You make me so nervous.
Oh, do I? My impetuosity didn't make you nervous.
O'Neill and Moya were present in the ruins when Con was shot, then they must have been witnesses of the deed. Since then, they have disappeared. It struck me that those who killed the boy must have had some reason for removing all evidences of the transaction.
Well,
he's right.
I questioned the constabulary and find they had no hand in it. The deed was done by a posse of fellows assembled to assist in the pursuit by a police agent named Harvey Duff.
Harvey Duff?
Do you know him?
He has thought an eye while we have been blundering, blinded by our tears. We could not see, deafened by our complaints. We could not hear. Oh, forgive me, Captain.
There she goes again. I've done nothing to deserve all this.
Nothing? How on earth, the fox? You've drawn the badger. Now that Rogue is in our sight, the course is clear.
It is? I confess I don't see it.
These two girls were the only witnesses of the deed. No one else was present to prove how Con was killed.
Exactly, yes. I was there. Alive! I'm dead.
Why, you provoking vagabond! Is this the way you play upon our feelings? Are you hurt?
Well, I've a crack over the lung and a scratch across the small of that. Do you know, miss, if I hadn't got him to shoot, you'd have never got the signal.
Brave fella. How did you escape?
And his gang waiting outside to murder us. But we gave them the slip, and while the master got away, I led them after me to St. Bridget's Abbey. And then after I got two shots out of him, I rode down the lane as far as a sack of potatoes.
Ours and Moya were in the road.
They were standing by and trying to screech blue murder. Stop running out, said a voice that I knew was Kinchilla's, and Sullivan had already whipped them up and put them into a car that was waiting outside. After that,
granted to the Premium prisoners.
A pardon!
I congratulate you. you, sir.
Oh, by Jove!
Excuse my swearing, but a light breaks in upon me. Kinchel and you of this part. I'll go to Ballyragan House at once.
Wait, I've just come from there. I went to tax him with his villainy, and he has fled.
I thought there was no fight in him.
But Arsene's power!
Arsene's power? What do you mean?
He loves her! He is carrying her off!
My wife! And her fortune! Ha! He played for a high game.
And on fighting he could not win, he stole half the stakes.
Ah, oh, this man is in league with a desperate crew. Half ruffians and half smugglers. Their dens, known only to themselves, are in the bogs and caves of the seashore.
I'll unearth him wherever he is. I'll hunt him. But let me honest, lad, of the county Sligo in the pack. And kill him. Rat.
And I'll send over to Sligo and get a warrant to arrest the fellow. I'd like to have the law on my side. If we are to have a hunt, let us have a license. Where shall I find you?
At my house.
No, give your own to Father Jordan.
Free and at home. Heaven be praised.
Not free to laugh and so.
What's your Christian name, or do you English have such things amongst you?
Yes, my Christian name is,
Harry! top of a noggin.
I don't come to disturb this melancholy entertainment. I mean this festive solemnity.
Oh, bless you for coming to admire the last of him. There he is. Ain't he beautiful?
The vagabond is winking at me. I've great mind to kick the cake from under him and send him reeling on the floor.
Too.
Please come on, we are in first.
I can feel the rope from Vanessa.
The other end is choking me.
Come on, let's get out
of here. Are you alive?
That's what I am. Burler, Eliza to see you two hang for. I'd be at your answer, but Gara would give you a fine character. Now, it is Fuzzy, the door is shut, and I've the cage. You're in the fine threat now. Made a mistake last night.
You forgot the bushel at your bed. Sir, we made a mistake last night. We can repair.
Just
lay out again, come to the way you were. Gamble a salary wiser.
Help! Help us!
saved you. The Mars went on.
Shut the windy and quiet him. Drop your weapons. Do you hear what I said? Drop your weapons. Now, one of you open the door.
See if you were part of still, Miss O'Neill. You despise me now. But never fear. After another month or two, we'll be getting on fine together.
Do you dream you can keep us here for another month? Why, before a week has passed, there's not a sod in the county Sligo but will be turned out in search of us. And then we'll see who looks the paler. You or I.
Before midnight. You'll be safe on board a lugger that lies snug beside this shanty. And before daylight, you and I will be on our way to a delightful retirement together, where you and I will spend our honeymoon together.
And what's to become of me?
I'll take care of you.
Oh, you can't, darling. Oh, I know.
And the tide is serving an hour. Come, please. On board is the worst, if you please.
Kitchener, I implore you not to add this cardiac to your list of crimes. Release me and this girl. And on my honour, I will bear no witness against you, nor any of those concerned in last night's park.
It is too late.
Kitchener, if you have any respect, any love for me, will you see me outraged?
Robert Folliot has returned.
Away with them!
Keep your hold. I go easy.
Robert Folliot is pardoned. He's hunting the box this minute without the County Sligo at his back.
Never fear. They can't discover this place till we're gone. No one ever knew of it but our own fellows.
And Con Shaughran.
Wiped out.
We are safe.
Go back to your post in the cliff and keep watch while I get these girls aboard.
I'd be uneasy in my mind to clear of this, though.
Robert Foley, I'm pardoned. And after all the trouble I took to get him convicted, and this is the way a loyal man is treated. I'm betrayed. No matter.
He's gone around the rest of the pack. Now what'll I do till the master and the captain come up? Where can I hide? Now if I could get behind one of them big hogsheads, or inside one of them now.
No!
There was a cry. It was Miss O'Neill's voice. Well, I'm only one against 20, but I'll make it lively for them while it lasts.
Track Harvey Duck.
What'll I do?
principal offender?
Is he dead?
I fear not. The bullet has entered here, but has struck something in his breast. This pocketbook has saved his life.
Where am I?
You are in custody.
What for?
For an attempt to assassinate this gentleman.
He was a felon! Escaping from justice!
He was a free man! And you knew it, as this letter proves!
Oi!
Do you hear me? Must I speak twice?
Take him away.
Aye, take me away quick, don't you hear him? Suppose that was a little...
of a night.
Why, I'll go bail, I won't.
And to drink?
I'll take care there's no hole in the thimble.
I won't trust either of you. You've deceived me so often before. Can you find anyone to answer for you?
Ah, murder, what'll I do? Name the friends I have in the world, Baron Tathers. Nah, they won't. Try. She says you'd go bail for me.
I didn't.
You're the only friends I have in the world. Long life to you. Many's the time you've looked over my faults. Will you be blind to them now? And hold out your hands once more to your poor Shaughran.
Thank you.
one special announcement to make tonight. It's a very special night for one of the members of our cast. It is actually Con the Shaughran's 17th birthday today. I'd like to give her this present from all of us and from her friends.
Thank you.